you know, hear these players' thoughts and opinions on these sorts of matters.
I'm very excited. So hopefully now we can roll to the video and you can, you know, see a little bit more about these players.
My name is Cedric. I came from France, Paris.
Hi, to introduce myself, I'm Philip Schulz, and I recently made the second place at the Dortmund Regional, and I'm here in London to claim the title of European champion.
I feel very happy to be a champion, to win Liverpool tournaments, and I'm very proud to play testing every year to this result.
So, I am playing the Pokemon trading card game because I started to play it a long time ago, and I met a lot of friends through it and traveled a lot, and I generally enjoy the game, so I like to play it a lot, and yeah. That's just why I keep going.
I play Pokemon because Pokemon is a community. Community is very cool, very impressive. I love this big event, and I recommend to everyone to play it.
Going into this championships, I expect a lot of competition, especially international players. I'm really curious to see how they'll do in Europe, because usually we don't have this kind of tournaments here. And yeah, I hope to get a strong position in the rankings and maybe get a title.
And there we see, you saw him in the video and you see him there right now, Philip Schulz, ready to face down against Tristan Wagner. So, Philip is going to be playing a Yveltal EX deck today, a deck we've already seen a lot of. It's just very popular, very strong, you know, it's done well pretty much the past three or four regionals in a row that we've seen both in the US and over here in Europe. So it's no surprise to see, you know, a player of his caliber playing this deck.
I'd be surprised if we didn't keep seeing it all weekend. It is the best deck around. It is absolutely brilliant. He's got a very good list. Obviously, we'll go into that as we go through. But you can see opposite them here, we've got Tristan Wagner, a fantastic player who's been around for a very long time. He is going to be playing, and this is a game I wanted to see on stream, a deck I wanted to profile today. He's playing Vileplume, Carbink, Zygarde, using Zygarde EX to do decent attacks for fairly low energy costs, Carbink to block EXs and get energy out, and Vileplume to block item cards.
Yeah, it should be a very, very interesting matchup here, and we are go, so it seems like Tristan is going to go first here, and he seems like he's got a decent opening hand. He's going to start off with a level ball. He'll probably be using that to either search for another Oddish or for a Carbink. Of course, the Carbink that's pretty much, I think all Carbink, the decks that play Carbink tend to go for in either the bigger quantity or entirely, is one with the Safeguard ability. We can see that's the one that he's eyeing up there as he looks through his deck. This, of course, makes it so that it's invulnerable to damage and effects of attacks from EX Pokemon, which is very, very handy.
It is very, very nice here. Of course, these Yveltal decks, you know, they really revolve around Yveltal EX. Now, interestingly enough here, Philip is not actually playing anything other than one Jirachi and the EXs. He's playing a 3-3 Garbodor line, one Shaymin, four Yveltal and a Jirachi. Clearly here, as we see Tristan playing an N, clearly he is thinking, right, I am just going to be the fastest, most consistent Yveltal EX deck there is. And that works in a lot of games. But when you've got a Pokemon there with that Safeguard ability, I think that Philip is going to struggle here to really just start attacking all of these Carbinks.
Yeah, it's a bit of a funny one for him, because we've seen that a lot of the Yveltal decks that have seen success recently have focused more on the Fright Knight Yveltal, of course, with that devastating ability that shuts off tools, one of the very few things that can actually do anything to tool cards right now. But Philip going the complete polar opposite direction from what we saw Alessandro earlier, for example, playing four of the Fright Knights, he's just playing four of the EX, so he really focused down on just, you know, this Evil Ball Y-Cyclone strategy, which is, you know, come in, just been effective for basically as long as it's been legal. As soon as Yveltal EX came out back in, we would have been 2013 at this point, it was good. And even now, we see it at the top tables of tournaments.
We do. Now, the one thing we do need to bear in mind is that fighting resistance from Yveltal EX here,
absolutely,
which is going to be big. But one other thing that's going to be big here, that Forest of Giant Plants that Tristan just got down on the field, it allows him to evolve his grass Pokemon whenever he likes, and he's just searched for a Vileplume. That makes me think he's got a Gloom in hand, and as soon as that Vileplume goes out, neither player gets to play item cards. There we go. Item cards are gone for the rest of the game now, essentially, and that means that Philip goes second He doesn't get a single turn of item cards. That's not very nice.
Yeah, if you're Philip right now, you've got to be looking at it and thinking, oh, why me? What did I do to deserve this? We literally just see him attach a dark energy to the active Yveltal and pass.
And here's the thing. It's not just that he's got no item cards. That is mean enough. But safeguard. So you can't attack the Carbink. And if I'm Tristan in this game, I'm just going to sit there and rock my Carbink break all game. And I'll build up some, you know, I might build up a Zygarde or two on the bench. Now, one thing that could be really, really big here, could have been, is that Fright Knight Yveltal turning off those Pokemon tools. Because one thing these Vileplume decks really dislike is when the Vileplume gets Lysandered into the active and they don't have a Floatstone to retreat. So if he could have got a Fright Knight Yveltal into the active, he can Lysander the Vileplume, Vileplume gets stuck in the active, and he just does 60 and then 60 to a bench Pokemon. Or maybe even just waits for Tristan to run out of cards and deck out.
Yeah, of course, because once that Fright Knight ability kicks in, then of course the Floatstone will have no effect at all, regardless of whether it's attached or not. But with Tristan in his current setup, I mean, it's just such a devastating turn one. Literally, all he needs to do is evolve up to that Vileplume, and yeah, Philip having no turn of items mean that, because one strategy that Philip could have used if he'd gone first is just turn one, focus down on getting a Trubbish with a Floatstone, then that way next turn, even if Tristan does get a turn one Vileplume, all he needs to do is evolve it to Garbodor, and he'll be able to shut off the irritating pollen ability and be able to play items again. That's no longer an option for him because the Vileplume just went down straight away. So Philip's just left in a really tricky position.
And it is a little bit of a race here, because if Philip can get a Trubbish with a tool attached before the Vileplume comes out, then Garbodor turns off Vileplume. But if the Vileplume comes out first, you can't put a tool on Trubbish, and because of the 3-2 Garbodor line here, there's no Hex Maniac in Philip's list. He has no way of turning off that Vileplume. Garbodor only does it when there's a tool attached, and he cannot attach tools because tools are items.
Yeah, it's a bit of an awkward one. We see there Tristan using Power Gem for 60, minus 20 for the resistance, puts him on 40. Of course, there's no energy in Tristan's Discard Pyre right now, so you may as well use the attack of the lower Carbink. And Philip there playing a Paralysis City just to get it out of his hand and then going for an end as well. It's very important that Philip, and he's aware of this, obviously being the high caliber player that he is, to play as many cards as possible just to get them out of his hand so that it increases his likelihood of drawing what he needs most right now, which is Pokemon and energy, because really, that's all he can, and obviously another supporter for next turn would be good, but just playing as many of those cards out of his hand to increase his odds of drawing into things he can actually use right now is how he's going to get back into this game.
I do worry a little bit here about Philip's chances of winning, because generally you play 2 Lysander, you play 4 Versus Seeker, but of course the Versus Seeker are out now. You can't play Versus Seeker. So that means he can Lysander 2 EXs off the bench to take 4 prizes, but where are the last 2 coming from? And we did see Jirachi coming up there, getting rid of the strong energy. He now has immunity.
Yes, he does. Although, at the same time, in terms of the immunity here, there's not really much value being gained out of that for Philip right now, because it's, you mean, you stop one turn of damage, but then equally, the Jirachi's only doing 10 a turn to the Carbink, and of course, Tristan isn't going to attach another strong energy to it now that, you know, the first one's already gone, so it buys him a turn, but that's really all it does.
And I am seeing signs from Tristan here that he is not wanting to 5-hit KO the Yveltal.
I would be very surprised if that was something he actively wanted to do. Yeah, it looks like he's going to get this Zygarde ready on the bench. And again, opting, I think it was actually the only choice he had. But I imagine if he did have a strong in hand, he would have opted to, you know, attach the regular basic to it rather than the strong, although you do see now using the Diamond Gift attack from the Carbink break, attaching the strong from the discard that he discarded earlier.
Now, there is a possibility here that Philip can Lysander and KO that Zygarde, but of course, if he does, then Tristan's just going to come up and bring up that Carbink break and just build up another attacker on the bench.
Yeah, and we saw there another cool play from Tristan there, attaching the strong energy to the Carbink break, and of course the Power Gem attack doing 40, the strong energy bumps up to 60, which actually knocks out the Jirachi.
That was very, very nice play from him there. He got the KO, so he is now one prize up. And a Lysander here, if he doesn't have a Lysander, we're very, very close. No, we are game over here, because that Zygarde can do 100 with his third attack. The strong energy and the resistance will cancel each other out, and that will mean that the Yveltal's getting KO'd, although he has benched a Shaymin to prolong it by a turn or two.
I mean, I think he benched a Shaymin just because he needed to draw more cards, but yeah, obviously that does give him an extra turn as well. Tristan getting delinquented here, but really just, you know, gets to discard three things he probably wouldn't care that much for anyway.
It's the nicest delinquent I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Pokemon I don't want and two items I can't play.
Yep, really just can't ask for much more favorability than that. And we see now that Tristan is looking, he's pretty much deciding what he wants to do at this point. Of course, the Vileplume's irritating Paladin ability affects both players, so equally Tristan wouldn't be able to attach his... he doesn't play Power Memory. This makes sense. We see that a lot of the Zygarde carving lists without Vileplume, they'll play one Power Memory just to, you know, give you that means of getting the one-hit knockout at any point in time. But instead, Tristan opted to play two Fighting Fury Belt just on the basis of, you know, maybe a couple of games before I evolve into Vileplume, I can attach a Fighting Fury Belt to a Zygarde and give it, you know, 230 HP. That's so much for a lot of decks to deal with.
It's absolutely massive. Now, Tristan here, I think this is going to be the turning point which makes this game very, very quick. Because what's going to happen is he's going to retreat the Carbink, and he's going to put up the Zygarde, and he's going to do the third attack, which will actually do 120, which will KO that Yveltal EX. And then Philip is sitting there and he's got a Shaymin double colourless. Whereas Tristan, he's got his Carbink Break with a strong energy, his Zygarde with two basic, two strong, and his Vileplume out.
And he's at no risk of Jirachi because it's already been KO'd. Philip only plays one and he can't play a Super Rod to put it back in.
I don't really see... I mean, Philip can bench a couple more Pokemon here to try and slow the game down a little bit, but, I mean, what's he going to do here? He can either not Sky Return, and Tristan gets two easy prizes off the Shaymin, or he does Sky Return, promotes his lone Trubbish, and then Tristan KOs that to win because Philip has no bench Pokemon.
Yeah, Philip needs to see another Pokemon off of this Ace Trainer, because if he doesn't, then, yeah, either way, he's not really doing much of anything.
If you go second against this deck, and your opponent gets a turn one Vileplume, turn two Carbink Break, there are very, very few decks which are going to be able to beat that. And I don't think it's a coincidence here that Tristan is 5-0. He has built this deck for consistency, and it's working. He's only a few turns into the game. He's three prizes up. He's got four energy on his Zygarde. And that is basically Philip just... Tristan took the KO there on the Shaymin. But then, so Tristan's got one prize left. I've seen many in my time, Nick. I've seen many 6-0 comebacks, but...
This is not one of them.
It's not one of them.
Yeah, Philip's going to concede game one there. Tristan Wagner goes one game up, and we will be moving on to game two. And really, I mean, that was just like a masterclass in Zygarde Carbink Vileplume at its, you know, full level of operation. Just, as you said, turn one Vileplume, turn two Carbink Break. Even if Philip managed to get the Jirachi to stall for one turn by discarding the strong energy, it just wasn't enough because, of course, the Break's being able to use the lower attacks of the Pokemon they Break evolve from, you just use Power Gem and then knock out the Jirachi with one strong energy.
It's upsetting. Very much, I mean, to be honest here. Because if you're Philip, and there's nothing he did wrong, he's a brilliant player. You know, we don't make these video productions against about any old player. They've got to be really good players. But the fact of the matter is that there's nothing Philip could have done there. Doesn't matter what he's doing, he was never going to win that game. The saving grace for Philip here, that was a very quick game. 10 minutes, start to finish, we're done. So that means he's got 20 minutes for game two, 20 minutes for game three, and he's going first in game two. That means, and the absolute priority here, he has got to get Trubbish Floatstone turn one, because if he doesn't get it turn one, I don't think he's ever going
to
get it.
No, they're definitely not. That needs to be the first priority here. And if he does get that, then he is in with a good chance. But there is a cheeky little tech that Tristan plays that we haven't mentioned. He plays one Mincino.
He does play one Mincino.
So he could use that to discard the Floatstone off of the Garbodor, and then as the Vileplume's already out, Philip's right back to square one.
And that is, and if we see Philip get the Trubbish Floatstone, we're going to want to see Tristan go and get the Mincino there. And the Mincino is not prized, which is very, very important. We just had a cheeky glance at the prize cam there. So that's very, very useful. And if there's no Vileplume here, then Yveltal's got to be the favourite. Resistance and all of his little tricks, your Max Elixir, your Garbodor, but... And, a Trubbish with a Fighting Fury Belt.
So I think what Philip's decided here is that the drawback of, you know, not having a Floatstone on a Trubbish is outweighed by just the advantage that having any kind of tool at all gives you. And also, bearing in mind that Tristan is playing, you know, a Vileplume deck, these Vileplume decks, they don't tend to play Versus Seeker, and Tristan's list is no exception. So Tristan will have to see one of his two copies of Lysander to be able to actually sort of punish Philip for doing that in any sort of way. And at this point, either he gets punished or he used that to be able to play items. So it's still it makes sense as the best thing to do.
No, I agree with you entirely there. And we get the second Trubbish down as well. And now, Philip, and this is the horrible thing, I dislike playing against Vileplume decks. And the reason is you get turns like this, where you sit there, and we can see it on Philip's face here. He's just no... Oh, there we go. Lysander straight away.
Yeah, but Tristan doesn't really have that much of anything. He's able to... Okay, he would have had the knockout with the... But the Fighting Fury Belt means it's not enough. Oh, no, really, it wouldn't have been enough anyway. But yeah, we see there, Lance Pulse going to do 20, plus an extra 20 for the Stadium Out, plus the Fighting Fury Belt makes 50 damage. But Tristan doesn't have much of anything in his hand. His last card in his hand is the Vileplume.
The strong energy would have been amazing there, but unfortunately it couldn't happen. Now, what I was trying to say before, but we got interrupted, something exciting happened. There's those turns when you're playing Vileplume where you just sit there and you're crossing your fingers, please don't get a Vileplume, please don't get a Vileplume. And if the opponent does, oftentimes there's just nothing you can do in the game. Philip here, no, you can see he's going aggressively. Two double colourless on the Yveltal, and what he's thinking here is, if I get a chance to attack, it's going to be a big old evil ball here. And there is a chance. If he can KO that Zygarde in the active, he's then got two Lysanders. Neither are prized. So he can then go Lysander, KO in the X, Lysander, KO in the X, and maybe he can... Or even Lysander, KO a Vileplume versus Seeker.
Yeah, it's definitely what Philip wants to do right now. And we see there him going for a third Trubbish as well. So I think maybe what he's going to try and do this turn, he might even be mitigating for any kind of tool removal. Obviously, he doesn't know that Tristan plays Machina in his list, but he probably knows that given Tristan is a very high-level player, has success before, that Tristan would be prepared for Garbodor, because you have to be. You know, if it's the one out that your opponent's decks can play against you, then having an out to your opponent's out just makes sense to include, especially if it's only one slot. So Philip is sort of, you know, almost thinking two or three steps ahead by just getting as many Trubbishes down as possible, so that even if, you know, one of them, the Trubbishes or Garbodors, has a tool discarded off of it, there's another Garbodor out ready to still negate the abilities and allow Philip to play items.
And he's pretty much got to give up that Trubbish in the active now. That Trubbish in the active is not lasting very long. Now, I thought I saw a Floatstone in his hand a minute ago, but I might have been seeing things. Now, he does play the Max Elixir here. He's got to look at the top six cards of his deck, find a basic energy, and attach it to a benched basic Pokemon.
The last card as well, the Max Elixir.
I mean, I don't think either of us surprised here, Nick, that he chose to put it on the Evil Tower there.
Definitely not.
So he's got a 5 energy Evil Tau, and you know he's going after that Zygarde, but that Fighting Fury Bout has in a very weird way actually done him more harm than good. Now, he had no way of knowing this, but Tristan whiffing the turn 1 Vileplume, combined with now not being able to pop a Floatstone on to retreat it, means that it's basically stuck there until it gets KO'd.
Yeah, at the same time, I think it's fine because this still affords Philip time to set up. But you can see now there's 6 energy on that Yveltal EX. So even with the Zygarde in the active having a Fighting Fury Belt on, I'm fairly sure that's, you know, not too many energy away from just being able to KO it outright regardless.
I'm just putting it out there. 6 energy, turn 2. That's pretty impressive.
And we see that double Floatstone on both of the Trubbishes as well. So yeah, Philip has got to be smiling about that setup right now.
I mean, this game, Philip's just going, right, I am going to do absolutely everything I can. I'm going to get double Trubbish with double Floatstone, and Philip could win this game very, very quickly. Because if he turns off the Vileplume and then just chucks up an Yveltal with, you know, presumably 7 or even 8 energy next turn, how's Tristan going to take it down? Oh, and a Delinquent!
I mean, it didn't make too much of a difference. Tristan was drawing dead regardless, and it seems like that's not really changed. He's kind of got his head in his hands there, just thinking to himself, again, you know, not really doing much, and he's just forced to free-hit KO a Trubbish, because, of course, the Trubbish, having not evolved, that Fighting Fury Belt actually applied the extra 40 HP.
Really,
so that was a 110 HP Trubbish, and another double colorless goes in the Yveltal as well. Professor Sycamore from Philip, like, I'm sorry, I really... In this particular game, I don't really see it going any way other than Phillips at this point.
I like, and we saw the third double colourless energy going down there. 8 energy. That means he's doing 180 damage to a Pokemon that doesn't have energy on as it is. Quite interesting at the moment, though, he's only actually doing 200. He doesn't yet have the KO.
No, he needs two more energy because Ligard of a Fighting Fury World gets 230, which is, as you might say, ludicrous.
It's ludicrous. Now, if he gets a Fighting Fury Bout Max Elixir, and I know he's already hit two Max Elixir here, Fighting Fury Bout Max Elixir, Philip might as well just sit there and be like, yep, I got this, boys. Because we've been talking a lot about the Garbodor turning off the Vileplume, and rightly so. But of course, the Garbodor also turns off the Carbink Safeguard, which is just as important.
Absolutely. And see there, Philip, actually hovering over Max Elixir. He does have it. Does he hit it here?
He doesn't.
Oh, no. That's unfortunate. I mean, he would have needed the Fighting Fury Belt as well. And from what I saw, it's not in his hand. So I don't think that would have been likely. But, I mean, at the same time, it's a shame to miss on something like that.
Now, here's the question. What do you put active?
I think, yeah, you just put this active. It's not under threat at all because, I mean, Tristan's limited to only one energy attachment per turn. And, yeah, there you go. Y-Cyclone makes absolute sense. Just doing a solid 90 damage and then he'll be able to follow that up with an Evil Ball next turn to get the knockout on the Zygarde.
That's what I would have done. You can't put the Yveltal EX in the active because, of course, he doesn't have free retreat. You can't let your opponent KO a Trubbish and you can't give up two prizes on a Shaymin. So I think that was the only sensible play. But it's a little bit upsetting when you're sitting there with eight energy. You've attached eight energy and you still can't get a one-hit KO.
Yeah, we see there Tristan did finally draw a second energy, so he was able to attach and do Cellstorm, of course, lets you do 60 damage and then heal 30 from his Pokemons. I'd say it's arguably Zygarde's best attack because being able to, you know, just heal 30 constantly whilst also, you know, punishing your opponent is just really strong. Of course, the 30 heal there not being enough to withstand this huge Evil Ball from the Yveltal EX in the active.
I would say in Vileplume Zygarde decks, I absolutely agree that it's the best attack because your opponent is generally left using attacks they'd rather not be using, weaker attacks, and then you can sit there and heal. Certainly, I think we can both agree that it is a very, very nice attack, and I think we're going to see a Lysander here onto the Carbink, and if I'm Tristan and my board is an Oddish and an Oddish, I am not feeling good about my chances in this game.
Neither am I. I mean, it does depend. Tristan could next turn just draw Professor Sycamore and then just absolutely explode. But at the same time, because so much time has passed, and at this point, if Tristan does decide to concede, they'd leave 30 minutes left for game three. So we'd actually, you know, see a full series play out. But he's going to play this Trainer's Mail, and he does see an Ultra Ball off of that. So, like, I'm not sure if he... Because if he only has one card in hand, which, yeah, he does, so that Ultra Ball, not going to do much good now, but next turn, we'll be able to search him something. But by that point, I think it will almost certainly be too late. And, yeah, if I'm Tristan, I'm thinking here, look, I might just cut my losses. We have so much time left, and if we could just go to game three and win, then, you know, especially if I get that same setup I got game one, then that might actually be the best strategy going forward.
I agree. I mean, I don't see how Tristan really wins here because even if his attacker here is Zygarde EX. Zygarde EX is not a big, at least for a couple of turns, he's not a big powerhouse. He is a chip away at you while you can't play any item cards. Yeah. But that's not his option here because you cannot chip away at a 6 energy Fighting Fury Belt in Yveltal EX.
No, definitely not. Although Tristan opting to play out all the way, maybe, you know, he's the sort of player who thinks, no, you know what, no matter what, it's not over until it's over. I'm just going to, you know, give it the best shot I can regardless. And, I mean, also at this point, it doesn't make too much of a difference because, I mean, Philip is only two prize cards away from winning the game regardless. And if he does see, you know, a nice draw of the Shaman, he could maybe pull something off. And, oh no, but of course not, the Garbodor is in play, so you can't do anything. No, it doesn't matter.
I applaud Tristan for trying there. Yeah. And just to confirm, Philip did win game two.
Yes, I think that was very, very sort of plain to see there. Yeah, just with the Garbodor combined, everything means that Shaymin was no longer an out. So there's really nothing Tristan can do at that point. And we will be going into game three.
And this, I think, sums up Vileplume decks beautifully. I think kind of like we saw in round one, but round one was much slower. We've just seen both sides of the matchup. Philip just won by doing what he would need to do to win. He needs a big Yveltal EX and a Garbodor, and he sweeps. Whereas Tristan needs to get the Vileplume and the Zygarde, turn off items, and this is what is utterly, utterly crucial here. Tristan's going first. And we saw in game one, if Tristan goes first and Tristan gets item lock going, there is nothing Philip can really do.
Yeah, this is going to be the sort of the key decider here. And Tristan, if you're Tristan right now, you've got to be thinking to yourself, I want to repeat game one, not of game two, please.
I mean, Tristan did not have good draws that last game.
No, definitely not.
when you're playing a stage 2 deck, even one like Vileplume, you've got, you know, 3 Vileplume, 3 Gloom, 3 Oddish, 4 Forest of Giant Plants. I mean, sorry, 3 Forest of Giant Plants. That's interesting. He's only playing the 3. Obviously, it's working very well for him. You need to draw one of each of those 4 cards on turn 1, and that is not always very easy. Now, he is playing 3 Shaman EX, which is going to help him greatly, but if he doesn't get the turn 1 Vileplume, then Robin, and we saw it last game, sorry, Philip, he's going to be going Trubbish, Floatstone.
Yeah, there's 2 Schultz brothers. One of them is on the stream over here with us today, but Robin is unfortunately not.
They are both excellent players.
They are. They're 2 of Germany's best, definitely. And equally, in fact, if anything, it's a brother face-off, because, of course, we have Gawain Wagner as well, who's Trista's brother. It's a showdown of siblings, you would say.
I think that's a very nice way to put it indeed, Nick. Yep. Now, here, the entire impetus of this game is going to be what is going to happen. Oh, 1 Forest of Giant Plants prized, I don't like. When you're only playing 3 and 1's prize, that means he's got 2. And if he doesn't draw it, turn 1, he's going to struggle to get that Vileplume. Also, yeah. 2 strong, not lovely.
Not lovely, but having said that, Tristan's hand is 1 billion times better than it was in Game 2. It's actually, he actually play cards, which, you know, is always a plus.
Playing cards in the Pokemon trading card game, always a plus.
Definitely, and we see there, to train as well, he's going to grab himself a Floatstone. Nice to see that early, so just to make sure that the Oddish show, and eventually what will become the Vileplume, is just workable. And he has a support as well, he has an Ultra Ball. He's got plenty to work with here, so I fancy his chances of getting to turn 1. Obviously, having the 1 Forest of Giant Plants prized kind of hurts, but I mean, there's still 2 left in his deck.
Oh, Nick, we're talking about prizes. Look what we've missed. 2 Garbodor prized. Philip can't get Garbodor this game. Both his Garbodor are prized.
How? Oh, my goodness.
And that means, and it's not just about the Vileplume, remember, he can't hit the Carbink. His only ability lock is Garbodor. Both his Garbodor are prized. Unless he starts taking a prize, he can't hit Carbink. Only advantage, they will be the first 2 prizes he takes.
Well, assuming he goes in a normal prize-taking order, because, you know, some players, they like to, you know, take prize in random order sometimes, you know, just because they're superstition or whatever else. But yeah, assuming in the normal prize-taking order, then that might be okay. That would be okay. But also, it depends on whether... Okay, I guess Tristan's meant too much stuff at this point, because if you could somehow figure out that Philip had 2 Garbodor prize, and I'm not sure he would, because really there's no way even Philip would even know at this point, but that would have been incredible if he could somehow figure that out and just not bench anything else apart from the Carbink.
And that would win him the game. That would guarantee him the win. It would be one long game. In fact, we might even go to a draw, because you're hitting like 20, 40 damage a turn. But, and that's actually what you said earlier. You mentioned about the Fighting Fury bout for the Zygarde. Lovely example of that now. 230 HP Zygarde. And that's not very nice for Philip to have to face down. So, second Oddish gets the Floatstone there. And, no, he still hasn't hit the Forest of Giant... Oh, he hits the Forest Giant Plants. And he hits the Gloom. Did he hit the Vileplume?
He hasn't. And unfortunately, there's no Ultra Ball either. So, whilst he's going to have a decent turn 1, it's not going to be as good as his game 1 start. And he's going to have to be content with a pass there. I'm fairly sure...
He's got to retreat into the Carbink. Oh, now this actually, and there's no way of knowing this, that could turn out to really come back and bite him. If Philip gets a turn 1 attack and knocks out the Oddish, we assume the prize he's going to take is his Garbodor, and when he takes that Garbodor off the prizes, then that changes everything.
It does. Having said that, Philip would still need a fair bit to get off the turn 1 attack. Obviously, it would be made a lot harder if Tristan had managed to get the Vileplume out, but he hasn't, so Philip will have access to all of his items for this turn at least, and I mean, yeah, he could do like a Max Elixir double colorless to, you know, charge up an Evolt EX on the bench. And yeah, we'll see if that's possible for him. He's opting to attach double colors to the active, so it's actually quite unlikely now that he will actually be able to get off a turn 1 attack.
It is. I mean, for Philip, and when he searches his deck, I assume he's going to be fairly upset. I would be if I found that out.
Yeah.
But what he's going to need to do here is still get the Trubbish, and he actually plays 4 Floatstone, which is very unusual, even in Garbodor decks. If he can get the Trubbish and Floatstone down, then at some point, maybe he Lysanders a Shaman or a Vileplume, gets a KO, draws a Garbodor, and then we are rolling. So he still wants to build up a giant Evil Tal in the active. That's still his plan.
Yeah, definitely. It just means that, yeah, with the Garbodor... And, okay, he's going for his first deck search now, so... the what we have to want now is he going to notice? I mean, he's looking through his whole deck, so I imagine he's going to see it. And we could like just read the reaction on his face when he eventually sort of sees that. Or, of course, he won't want to give it away, but I think he's going to try and keep a good poker face here once he realizes what's going on.
Nobody looks through that. The thing is, when you look through your deck, you generally search. If somebody looks through and then takes a nice long look back through, they're looking for different cards. When they have a look through and then immediately have another look through and a third look through, that means they're checking again and again for the same card. Another nice thing to look out for at tournaments. That there was Philip definitely looking at going, and if I'm Tristan, I know he's got something prized, which surprises him. Because a normal deck search is nice and slow, and then you go backwards nice and slow. You don't look through three times quickly.
Yeah. Obviously, different players' mannerisms are different sometimes, but the general trend is, you know, you can try and look out for stuff like this and, you know, make your best judgment on why people act in a certain way. It's the sort of, David was talking about the sort of the poker elements of the game earlier.
And absolutely.
Yeah, and this is where that comes in.
And again, I still love this. He's got the Yveltal in the active with the double colourless. He's got the Trubbish on the bench with the floatstone. This is good. He's still going for his setup. Now, he doesn't know this, but we know that as soon as he takes the prize, he's got that Garbodor, and as bad as he's feeling now, he will feel relieved to that same extent when he draws that Garbodor and then gets to turn off those abilities, and that could change the game. He still got the floatstone before Tristan got the Vileplume.
Yes, absolutely, which means that if Tristan really does want to, you know, shut off the Garbodor to make himself be able to block items with the Irritating Pollen ability again, he would need to go for his Mincino and clean up that floatstone right off that pile of garbage.
That was quite good, I'll give you that one. Mincino is going to be big for Tristan here, and Tristan knows his Mincino isn't prized, so at some point, and there we go, Vileplume. So we've got the trainer lock here, the item lock, I should say.
Yes.
We did rename that a couple of years ago. So the item lock's going to come down here, and Tristan's going to need that Mincino. If Philip grabs the Garbodor off of his prizes, that turns off the Vileplume. But then, of course, all Tristan needs to do is grab the Mincino to get rid of the tool on the Garbodor, to turn off the Garbodor and turn on the Vileplume. But here, we just see a nice attack for what would have been 70 if it wasn't for that pesky resistance.
Yeah, so Tristan going to have to be content with doing 50 here instead, and it seems like the judge is trying to point out that maybe there was some wrong damage calculation, but no. We go Lance Pulse, does 20 base, 20 extra for the Stadium in play, 20 extra for the Strong Energy, 10 extra for the Fighting Fury Belt, minus 20 for the Yveltal extra resistance, 50 damage.
Yes. Now, the thing is here with Tristan, I would have loved to have seen him get the breakout last turn.
Yeah, that would have been his ideal play, because then, of course, he can just start walling with that and really force Philip into an awkward position where he needs to see a Lysander to actually do any sort of damage.
Because when I'm watching games, you know, whether it's a tournament or, you know, wherever I am, whenever I'm watching games, I'm always a little bit jealous of the information that the players have that I don't. I love these prize cams here, because now I have that information about Philip's prizes and about Tristan's prizes. And honestly, here, Tristan doesn't know it, but Zygarde is the wrong attacker here, given the specific circumstances of what's in Philip's prizes. Because, well, Yveltal against Zygarde in a straight shot here in the trading card game, Yveltal's the better attacker.
Yeah, absolutely. Even if Tristan does Cellstorm here and heals 30, I'm fairly sure with another double colors attachment, Philip could actually just get the knockout on that Zygarde, and he doesn't even have an extra energy to attach, so he's going to have to content with another Lance Pulse for 50.
And there's going to be some relief with Philip, because if he takes prize like most people do, when he knocks out that Zygarde, he's going to draw two Garbodors.
Yeah.
And I'm starting to think Philip might be moving into the driver's seat here.
Quite possibly. He's debating whether to possibly play a Delinquent, but it looks like he's deciding not to. And also, he doesn't have the extra double colorless to take the knockout now, which is a bit unfortunate for him. So he's instead going to be content with doing White Cyclone, 90 damage, and moving the double colorless onto the Yveltal EX on the bench for when this one in the active will, you know, likely be knocked out.
Yes, and the lack of Southstorm here, you know, if he'd got the Southstorm last turn for two energy, Lanzrath here would have got the KO. Yeah. Missing that energy attachment means a Zygarde goes down before the Yveltal rather than the other way around. Oh, no.
Of course, the Southstorm, there's no fight to fear about on that Yveltal, the X in the active, so the Southstorm is going to do enough.
I completely forgot, yeah. Sorry, that was very silly of me. He was actually doing 70 damage with Southstorm, and that was enough.
Yeah. Exactly on the nose.
Alrighty then, so actually that energy attachment didn't hurt him at all. He got the KO on the Evil Tau, and this is why Y-Cyclone was such a good attack last turn. He's got another Evil Tau to bring up, get the KO. There is the Delinquent, although actually it's probably item he can't use, Stadium he no longer needs.
Again, very, very nice Delinquents here. And there we go. We see Philip does take the two Garbodors off of the prizes, and he must be looking at it and thinking, lucked out there a little bit.
There was a little bit of a nod there, but he's got a poker face.
Yep.
He really is very good at not giving anything away. This might be why I don't, you know, always win these big tournaments, because when I grab both the Garbodors I desperately need off my prizes, I am delighted and I'm not very good at hiding it.
We want to, you know, fist pump the air and, you know, just say, oh yeah, I've got it.
Now, if Tristan can find an N here, and he does play four, that could be like the ultimate insult.
It could, but unfortunately he doesn't. He instead just sees a Sycamore, and I'm not sure if he noticed Ross, but he just had to discard his Mincino because he didn't have enough space on the bench.
Oh no! And he's thinking here, Philip's not got his Garbodor, he's not being able to get it out, I don't need the Mincino so much. And here, and I think Philip, especially with the Mincino just going down, Philip here, he's going to evolve up to the Garbodor. He's going to go ahead, and I believe he'll have enough to get the KO, especially if he adds another. Oh, actually, yes, yeah, so now he is. He's going to be hitting for 100 here, which I don't think will quite get the KO, but he's going to be very close, especially if he can add some energy on there, yeah. At which point the game is effectively over, I might think.
I'm not entirely sure why Tristan decided to attach the fighting scene to the active, given that he... I mean, I guess he isn't necessarily expecting the Garbodor, but at the same time, if he's going to do Diamond Gift anyway, he may as well attach to the Zygarde on the bench. And we see the, Philip playing a town map, so...
It's not cool, Philip.
No, cool. We can't see your prizes now. What's going on?
I mean, the important ones there were the Garbodor and, okay, they're both out. Now we got the Garbodor. Now we've got the thing. Now, Carbink, yes, I was right. 100 wasn't quite enough, but with the extra energy, he's doing 110. 5 energy, 100, plus the 20 base is 120. He's got the Garbodor, so Safeguard gets turned off. Carbink Break gets knocked out. And now Tristan's got to be worried, because that Zygarde is not... I mean, maybe he can get the KO with Zygarde. I mean, a double attack doing the... Land's Wrath, I think it is, with the free energy.
Yes.
Two of those will get the KO as long as he's got one strong energy, which he has. So maybe he can still work this around.
Yeah, possibly. But again, it's that if Tristan hadn't attached the fighting to the active Carbink, then Philip would have actually needed to attach another energy to get the KO. So again, that sort of energy attachment on the active, considering he wasn't even using the attack that needs it, kind of backfiring on him a little bit.
I think had he put the energy on that Zygarde, it would have been better, because then he could start building up another Zygarde on the bench when the original one goes down. But as it is here, the Valtal's doing enough damage. Now, is he going to actually... No, it's sometimes looking like people have that look where they're going to use a Lysander. Now, Lysandering up the Zygarde here would, I believe, be the better play.
Yeah, especially at this point, the Carbink is no longer a worry, but it looks like instead opting to go for a Sycamore. But yeah, at this point, you can hit Carbink whenever, because of course the ability is now shut off, and you've seen Tristan discard that Mincino, and you know that it's very unlikely that he'll play something like Super Rod to get it back. Although, having said that, he does play one Brock's Grit, which obviously Tristan doesn't notice, but it is currently in the prize cards, which is unfortunate, to say the least.
And I'm pretty sure Philip's got a one-hit KO next turn. Now, we know he's got a double colourless in hand. Let's say that the Zygarde attaches a third energy. That's then going to give us 7 energy in total, plus the 20 base is actually going to be 160, plus the Fighting Fury Bat is 170, so attaching a single energy next turn will do the requisite 190 to get the KO. Even if Tristan doesn't attach a third energy to the Zygarde, then Philip can just attach a double colourless and get the KO, and he has a double colourless in hand at the moment.
Yeah, it's not looking brilliant right now. As you see there, the Carbink Break does go down. Tristan promotes the Vileplume, and... Yeah, I mean, he's not really left with a whole lot of options. You go for a Trainer's Mail, but I'm not really sure what he can see off this. He sees another Lysander. He already has one in hand, though, so that doesn't really bring him any extra benefit.
I mean, at this stage, I think, I'm not 100%, but I think Philip has got this game sewn up. Because what's going to happen here is either Tristan attacks with the Zygarde, and then it gets KO'd next turn, or He doesn't attack with the Zygarde, and if Philip finds a Lysander to grab the Zygarde into the active, then it gets KO'd anyway. At which point, Philip's got an Evil Tally X with a whole heap of energy on, dealing a whole heap of damage, and Tristan has two Shaymin, a Vileplume, and a Gloom.
Basically not doing much of anything.
None of those Pokemon, well, the only one of those that really does anything is Vileplume. Oh wait, Garbodor makes him essentially an empty, well, kind of it takes away a bench space without giving you anything.
Yeah. Oh, okay, we do see that this is one option that Tristan does have. You see him playing one of the Lysanders he has to get the knockout on the Garbodor. So now, of course, the Irritating Pollen ability is going to kick back in, and Philip won't be able to attach a Floatstone to the other Trubbish. So now what Tristan can do again is maybe try to find his other Carbink and Wall Safeguard.
That's his only real hope at this stage, because we're still seeing a KO on the Zygarde this turn.
Yeah.
Tristan's still not got any attackers, and of course, he's not in a position to search for the Carbink, because he can't be playing things like Ultra Ball. So even though, and that was a beautiful play by Tristan, getting rid of that Garbodor was a wonderful thing, it was the perfect thing to do, but it's not just about getting rid of the Garbodor, he's still got to take free prizes.
And Tristan has another issue now, he doesn't really have much draw option-wise, he's just forced to Lysander to bring up the Trubbish, and see one Dark Energy attached and a pass, and the thing is, even with, okay, we do see the end, I was going to say, if Tristan didn't end Philip, Philip had the Lysander ready in hand to just KO something on the bench with his Velta DX and just win the game, so it's really good that Tristan had the end there.
Yeah, that was a game-saving play there. He could have just Lysandered one of the Shaymin, taken the KO with Evil Ball, and that would have been, or would have been the game. That would have just been the end of it there.
Yeah, and it's going to be interesting to see whether, I mean, Tristan has discarded a lot already. He might potentially be out of Carbink. That would be a little bit awkward if that's the case. But we see that he draws a strong energy, a fighting energy, and an Ultra Ball. And to be honest, he doesn't really want to play the Ultra Ball straight away because he probably doesn't have that many energy left, full stop. So if he plays the Ultra Ball now, then he might not even be able to attach the Carbink and actually do damage.
And, I mean, he does have a third Shaymin if it's not in the discard pile already, but
I think, though, if he does that, then he draws the rest of his deck and loses.
I don't really know what Tristan does here. I'm not sure Tristan knows, and that's not in any way a criticism. It's just, I think Philip has backed him into a corner. He's taken key knockouts at key times.
Yep, and that's it. So Philip manages to draw the Dark Energy, retreats the Trubbish, and Philip Schultz is going to win rounds.
Congratulations to Philip there, and a very rough matchup for Philip, to be perfectly honest with you, because, you know, your item beat, and we saw game one, and we thought, well, if this keeps happening, there's no way Philip can win. But he kept his composure, he got his big Evaltely X's out, he got his Garbodor, and in game three, to be going second against a Vileplume deck, to find out both your Garbodors are prized, and still keep enough composure, because he played that flawlessly. Getting the Trubbish, getting the Floatstone, building up the Evaltely X, to be able to do all of that in, you know, under those circumstances was wonderful.
Yeah, I mean, if you're Philip, you've got to be smiling, and you saw he absolutely